Bit of kick on it. Anton has a beautiful Chiquita. He's a route one player. Has good feeling, but you won't see the same creativity as Truls Morgaard. Barely anyone has more. And I think that's one of the trademarks of Team Sweden, their feeling, a unique way of playing the ball. Perfect length on the touch, invites Anton in, but too short. It's a little bit lukewarm, that touch, and that is not hot enough. Jan Woojin will eat that up for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Already the crowd are getting a good idea of what kind of pace Jan Woojin offers. That is amazing, and Anton tried to go for the behind the back. Seen a few winners here, some chicken dinners. Both are going to want to improve their serving. The threat on either side, both sides, is evident straight away. That's a very captivating thing. Beautiful third ball. That was a smooth backhand. Schalberg grooving. Moving 1 point closer to level him. Got a lot of history, these two. The first time they played each other was at the 2013 World Junior Championships. Jan Woojin won that 4-2, and the most recent time they played was in 2019, four seasons ago, and Jan Woojin won it in the fifth, 3-2. Every time Schalberg has beaten Jan Woojin, it was 3-0. So some sporadic results between these two, but here now in the Infinity Arena for the first time against each other. We saw the whirlwind serve come back against Ma Long last week. Schalberg nearly beat the Dragon. Oh! We saw the motion there again, but it was the shovel that he went in for. I love it. I absolutely love that serve. The motion of it. Oh, the return of the whirlwind. Schalberg levels. Nice length. The South Korean speciality is playing a winner against a half long ball, a barely attackable ball. They can come around the side of the table to make space. Can't lob down Jan Woojin, the pocket rocket. He's got a divisive backhand, Jan Woojin. Doesn't play a lot of winners with it, but can put it in good enough positions to then make space for his forehand for the next shot. Excellent from Schalberg. Patient play. Picks out the right ball to attack there. Pinning Jang on the backhand side, and you can see the South Korean will try and chase that forehand. Ooh, the whirlwind comes out again, but you can see the level of precision you have to serve at to deny Jan Woojin that forehand. A sweeping stroke is honestly very poetic. That was a clever serve there. You can see there in the top left of your screen, Alexi and Felix Lebrun. Felix just not making the cut on world ranking, but Alexi will play the winner of Lee Sang-soo or Fan Jendong. Try the Chiquita. Going for more side spin on that flick. Trying to come around that side of the ball. View from the crew. Ooh, he escapes. There was good backspin at least on that push. Zhang would have had to come up the back of the ball a little bit more to make that shot on. And for the big killer, right into the middle of Anton Schellberg. And that middle area changes depending on where Schellberg is at the table. Look at Jorgen Persson, former world champion in singles of that legendary era. Especially legendary era, I should say, because there's still some legendary results happening courtesy of Swedish players in this current era of table tennis. Oh, he left it open, but Schellberg couldn't come through the open door. That's all cards on the table forehand, and he pulled an ace there, Zhang Wujin. Oh my word, he plays a winner! Goodness gracious me, Schellberg had to come up with something special there. And he did. Zhang Wujin couldn't even make contact on the ball, and he has arguably the fastest feet in the game. When you watch TT live for the first time, you'll be surprised how fast even a short serve can come at you. But Zhang Wujin took a little bit off and it made Schellberg stall. Second game point to Zhang Wujin. Just waiting for the ball girl to fill up the basket for the assistant umpire. After each rally, usually the ball will be replaced with a new one. The delicacy did it in the end for Zhang Wujin. The intricacy. Good change of direction. If you want to serve half long or long, it's got to be kind of against what Zhang Wujin expects, because he will scamper and want to play that forehand ASAP. Nice put away there. He's got a 59% win record, Schellberg, against Asian players. That was a lovely flick, wasn't it? Like Ma Long does, and actually using the same blade as the Dragon, Zhang Wujin will actually play quite a lot of touches. Take it really early to trap the ball. So what you're doing by touching the ball is you're basically making your opponent sometimes feel forced to push the ball long, and that tells me that Zhang Wujin is a lot more comfortable playing an open forehand against a backspin ball than the majority of players now at the top level, who would rather just flick straight away. You can see the trend there of Zhang Wujin. He is firing and flying around the Infinity Arena like we know and love him for. Oh, that's unfortunate there for Schellberg. He did ever so well. a bit too bouncy. And Zhang just swatted that one like a fly. It's like Anton's had a better success rate serving into kind of the wider forehand area. Good brush up, got a passive block, and then made a nice angle with the forehand. So glad to see this serve back. Barely saw it for a 3 or 4 year period. Broke onto the scene at the Swedish Open where he lost to Fan Jindong 4-2. Tried to just feel that ball on, but that was a loaded topspin. Zhang now with an over 60% win record. Points won on serve. Not straight from the serve, after he has served. Fooling flick. Leaves us speechless, shots like that. Opened up his racket face really early, but didn't show where he was gonna go. And now he's got the serves. Will he go into that forehand area again? Let's see. Here it comes. He did, but Zhang flicked that time. Salberg just couldn't come over that one enough to play the winner. First backhand was lovely, but Zhang did enough to just roll it back on. Used the Swede's pace. That's amazing. I think it did catch the edge slightly, but still, I think fortune favoured the brave there. Butchered backspin serve. You can hear the sound was really quiet because the contact was so fine when he came under that ball. Schlaberg would have had to do the equal and opposite to get it over the net, and the table surface was in the way. I think he's going for the right shots, but I just feel like he's making his mind up a little bit too soon. Schlaberg. He hits bombs. I mean, he's been at the top end of the player averages in the Bundesliga for ages, Schlaberg. He thrives when there's big crowds. But right now, the kind of fan support here is kind of neutral. Right off the bounce. That's the threat. Zhang Wujin call the timeout. Looks over to Chusei Hyuk, who gives him the thumbs up as though to say, no, it's okay. You got this. You're serving. Let's try and save it. I think you don't need it right now. That's the reassuring nature that a coach needs to be able to have. The calmness. Whoa, the ball stalled at the top of the net. And Schlaberg will be thanking the table tennis gods it did not come down on his side. He's done it. It only took a serve and a third ball. He's 2-0 up now, Zhang Wujin. That was clever from Zhang Wujin. Not sure what he was going to do there. Kind of made a bluff. As powerful and explosive and quick as he is quite crafty, Zhang Wujin. Quite techy. Got good awareness and nice feeling. Might see a Schlaberg timeout if Zhang wins this point. Or perhaps the next as well, on top of that. Great serve with backspin. The aftermotion really threw off Zhang. Honestly, it looked flickable. Two points straight off the serve. Barely a rally so far, and that shows really how much power these two have. Their power really outclasses their recovery. They're so powerful, I mean, so hard to recover from. You were on shot before a bullet's coming your way. And look at that. A taste of the own medicine there from Zhang Wujin with that forehand flick cross table. Alexia Lebrun, another European player who has really tricky serves. The lollipop, the windscreen wiper is a serve that's a big talking point now in the world of table tennis. 5-4. Looking at the draw, the winner of this match will play the winner of Matty Falk and Wang Chuqin. Oh, he made a good initial attack, but Zhang Wujin's placement into the middle made it tough for Anton Schalberg to play his forehand. Christian Carlsen there, a world doubles champion. The racket is lightly tossed here. Who's going to come in after Troels Morgaard on Anton Schalberg? Can't say it, and I wonder whether Sweden are keeping it a secret to try and take the world of table tennis by surprise. Something I've been thinking about for some time. 6 of the last 8 to Zhang Wujin. And that's beautiful length on that push from Schalberg. He apologised. Did it clip the edge slightly? Yeah. Looked to rush Zhang Wujin. Beautiful side swiping guided flick. There's not been enough answers to the formulas Zhang Wujin is bringing to the table. Schalberg can play that ball every single time, but Zhang Wujin just hasn't been giving him it. Forehand touching instead of flicking is a proven formula for success. We see Ma Long do it. But Zhang Wujin here has 4 match points. And he's done it. He beats Anton Schalberg 3 straight after 2 really closely contested games.